So after you've cut your pattern pieces, just follow the icon guides to lay them out and put them in place and tape together. Now we're going to cut our fabric from our pattern piece. We need two lots of pieces of our shorts. So what I'm going to do is lay it out on the fabric, on the straight grain of our fabric, and pin in place. So now we have our pins in place, take your sewing scissors and cut out the pieces. With the right sides of the fabric together, we're now going to sew our two front seams together and our two back seams together. For extra reinforcement, you might like to sew down the back seam twice. So now we overlock all of our open edges, and if you don't have an overlocker, then you can use a zigzag stitch on your sewing machine. So our two flat pieces are going to start to look like a pair of shorts because we're going to now sew our inside leg seam. So you might like to pin this before we sew it. We're ready to sew. If we were to sew the inside leg seam how the fabric wants to lie, it'd look something like this, which would be quite difficult to sew. What we do is we lay it flat. We make sure that all of our bulk of our fabric isn't under our sewing line, and that's the way we'll sew it. Of backward stitches for locking in place, and move our pins as we go. There we have our inside leg seam. So now we're going to overlock or zigzag our inside leg seam. And whilst we're at our overlocker, we're going to run around the lower leg edges and our waist edge of our pair of shorts. We're making our press mark for our casing for the waistband, and I'm using the pattern piece as a template, and if I push that underneath use the guide mark, push it up tight, and press. We can keep moving that all the way around, or once we get started we can eyeball the rest of it and press our elastic casing. To do our leg hems, we do the same as we did for our waistband. To make it easier, because this won't fit over our end of our ironing board, I just like to press it flat and then fold it. And we've got a 5/8 of an inch or 1 centimetre allowance, but you can make these a little shorter, or you can even sew your hem, leave a gap and put some elastic in to make some cute little bloomers. Before I do the other leg, I'm just going to do a simple check to make sure that our hems will be even. So now I'm going to create the elastic casing at the waistband, and we do this by sewing a line all the way around except for leaving a gap of 1.5 inches or about 3 centimeters. I'm going to leave a gap to insert the elastic. To get a nice straight hem on the shorts, what I'm going to do is move my needle to the left so that I can then line up my foot with the lower edge and get a really even hem. So I can do this by moving my needle. Some machines you can do it manually, mine I just press a button. And if you can't do that on your machine, then use a guide mark on your base plate and line up the edge that way. Now I'm going to sew straight through my overlocking, and if you didn't overlock, then you can just do a double fold and create your hem in a similar way. Sewing your hem of the leg means we're just going to be pulling from underneath, so that we're sewing through on a flat surface, making sure that none of our hem is caught underneath our needle. So to get the right length of elastic, measure the waist of your intended wearer and subtract about 2 centimetres or 1 inch. Then cut that. So for my wearer, her waist is 19 inches, so I'm going to cut this at 18. This is the tool I like to use to thread elastic, because I can clamp the elastic on the end and hold it into place and then thread it through my casing. If you haven't got one, a safety pin will work. clamp that into place and we're ready to go. Here's my casing. It's just a matter now of threading through the casing. The thing we have to be careful of when we're threading is that we don't twist the elastic, because trust me, I haven't met a child who'll wear a pair of shorts with a twisted elastic waistband. And push that through, making sure we don't pull the other end in. And we're ready to sew those together. So I like to hold them in place once I've threaded it all the way through. Give yourself enough leeway to put that under the sewing machine, and holding it in place will mean we don't twist it after we've threaded it. So I've got my elastic overlapped about almost half an inch or so. It's not an exact science, it's elastic, it has a lot of stretch in it. And what we're going to do is sew down, reverse a little bit to lock it in place. Sew all the way down with our needle down, up with our foot. I like to sew a little box shape, so sew that along, needles down, foot up, make a little box shape. To sew the casing closed, all I do is sew it from the right side so I can join up my two lines of sewing. So I've got that under my foot in place, and I'm going to sew forward and back